You've been enjoying it so far?
Yes, yes, very good indeed. Very good.
Do you do a lot of these kinds of events? Have you met fans a lot before?
This is the second one I've done.
And the last one, did you have any particularly memorable fan encounters? Any interesting, any funny experiences there?
No, not really. No, nothing. I was very amazed, because I'd never been to one before. And to see how everybody dresses up, it's wonderful, really.
Certainly some interesting things to see. Now, when fans do come up, what's the question you've been asked the most? Is there any particularly common one?
The question they ask the most is, they've all heard the story of that scene with the swordsman, and I just have to verify, you know, that it was a complete out-of-the-blue thing. So I was supposed to do a big fight with him, but he was ill, and they decided, oh, well, just shoot him. And that's how it came about. And they keep asking me that time again.
One thing I guess fans will probably be quite curious about, what was that original scene supposed to be? I mean, obviously, we've seen your twiddling of the sword originally, but what were you going to go on to do? What was choreographed?
In the script, it said he's being chased, and a fight. A huge Arab and a fight. And then we were sort of rehearsing, but there's not a lot you can do with a whip and a sword.
Yeah.
You know, I kept running at him and he kept ducking and I kept cutting things, and they said, no, it doesn't look very good. Plus he wasn't very well. Yeah. And I'd already done all that fiddling stuff. Yeah. And they broke for lunch, and during lunch they decided, oh, well, shoot him. That's it. And that's how it came about.
Why do you think that has become one of the most memorable scenes in what is still one of the greatest action films of all time? Why is it that particular scene that people are so enamored with?
I've got no idea. They did a thing in the Playboy magazine once, the top 10 scenes of the whole film industry. And I think that one was about number 5.
Well-deserved 5th ranking there, I think. Now, I mean, clearly, the Indiana Jones saga remains one of the most loved film franchises of all time. What do you think it was about that film, and particularly the style of action in those films, that have made it so timeless?
Well, it was like boys' own adventure stuff, wasn't it? And takes you all back to when you were kids, and that's why. And Spielberg is a brilliant director, and that's how it sort of took off.
Steven Spielberg is loved around the world. He's a genius. He's given us some of the greatest films of all time. People probably want to know, I mean, what's he like as a director? I mean, when he's working with you, what kind of direction does he give you? And is there anything that immediately distinguishes him from other people you've worked with?
No, he's terrific. I mean, you know, he just... He watches it on the monitor, and he knows exactly where he's going to cut. And all of a sudden he'll say, cut that. And you still carry on thinking that, but it's cut. He knows where he's cutting it. It's very good.
How did you first get started in stunts and the kind of action stuff that you became legendary for?
Oh, it's a long, long story. It sort of just happened. When I did my national service, I was in the Guards, the Welsh Guards. And I came out of the Guards and I kicked around and managed to get in as a film extra. And it sort of went on from there, because I was a big fella and I was fit, and they used to, when they wanted sort of tough guys and fight scenes, they always used to use the big guys. And it sort of, over the years, it progressed, and now it's a real sort of industry now, you know.
The industry has changed a lot, particularly the kind of action sequences we see on screen. What do you think of kind of modern action films? Because they're obviously very different from the kind of work you were doing on Raiders or the other indie film.
Well, now it's all CGI, isn't it? You know, it's not... I mean, after a day's stunting, when I was doing it, in the battle scenes, and you really knew you'd done a day's work, you know, covered in bruises. And now they've got all this body armour that they can wear, a neoprene, and they can take blows. It's different ball game altogether now.
As you've said, you've been involved in so many different productions, a lot of different fights. Looking back, is there any one in particular that you're most proud of that was the toughest to do at the time, or just that you're most proud of the finished product on screen?
Well, every fight scene you do, the reason they use stuntmen is because there's a chance of getting hurt. And when you do a fight scene with another stuntman, you really go for it. When you're working with an actor, you have to pull the punches. But when two stuntmen go at it, they really, you know, to make it look real, really. But I haven't got any sort of specific one. No, I can't think of one more than another.
Of course, I guess everyone always wants to ask this. As a stuntman, what's the worst injury you've had, and what's the worst injury you've given someone else?
Well, luckily, I haven't given anybody an injury, but I was doing a jousting thing, and I broke my wrist. I've broken ribs, sternum, cheekbone. That's it, you know, just breaks.
It's a wonder you're as handsome as you are now with all these injuries.
Somebody phoned me up the other day. They said, "You're still working, Terry?" I said, "Well, not really. I'm 80 years of age. I can fall down all right. I can't get up."
I guess final question before we let you get back to fans here today. If people want to follow in your footsteps, despite all of those war stories, and they actually would like to go into stunting, what advice would you give them? How should they get started in that?
Don't. Because it's hard now. To be a stuntman now, you have to get 6 qualifications, which costs an awful lot of money, in martial arts, riding, all, you know. And then you have to get work. And I think when I was doing it in its heyday, there was about, I would say, 60 stuntmen. I think now there's about 300. And it must be very hard to get work now. I was in a pub a little while ago, and a young lad came up to me and he said, you're Terry Richard. I said, yeah. He said, "I've just got on the register." They said, "They have a register." So I said, "Oh yeah, good." He said, he was only about 20. I said, "How long have you been on the register?" He said, "Oh, I've been on about 6 months." He said, "I haven't worked yet." I said, "Well," he said, "how do I sort of get in?" I said, "Well, you just have to keep punching and get in with a stunt arranger. They're the ones, the arrangers are the ones who get the stuntmen in. So keep trying, you know, but it's hard. Costs you a lot of money. But the rewards are great if you work."